Hello YouTube, this is a video write-up for the challenge Diversity for 30 points in the Cryptography category of HackCon CTF 2018. So the challenge prompt here is so much diversity my mind boggles, and we're given this text, which looks like it has a lot of numbers, with supposedly a B prefacing, an X prefacing, a D prefacing, and an O prefacing for different kinds of numbers or data, just represented in different ways, maybe base 2 or base 16 or base 10, etc., etc. So binary, hexadecimal, decimal, and octal. So let's go ahead and just convert all these to what we would expect to see and then see if they actually translate into anything else. So I'm going to open up my terminal. I'm just going to create a script here that I can work with them. Go ahead and make a shebang line for Python, and I'm going to make a string for this, just call it S, and we'll start to work. So what I want to do is going to go ahead and replace, just kind of a quick and easy thing to remove all the spaces with a B, the preface it, to change them to a space 0B so it puts them in a form that Python can understand. The only thing that we're going to miss here is this very first binary value because there is no space prefacing this. So I'm just going to put a 0 there and that'll make things easier for us in the long run. And we'll do the same thing with the hexadecimal values. We'll put a 0x instead, taking note of the space, so we'll keep track of all those. And that way Python will be able to handle them very easily. Same thing with octal. And for decimal, it's a little bit different because Python doesn't use a D to preface a decimal number. It just doesn't have anything to preface it. It's just the regular number. So if I wanted to, I could print out S now and view it, and we have all of these in a form that Python could understand if we were to just slap this in a Python interpreter. Let's go ahead and actually make it an array so we can handle it pretty easily. So I'm going to change all the spaces to commas, and I'm going to go ahead and say S can equal start of a brace here with the string added in, and same thing with an ending string brace here. So we've got all this now, and Python can handle this very, very easily if we let it eval this. However, I don't want to just straight up eval because that's kind of bad. What I'm going to do is I'm going to actually just get it from the pwn module because they have a safe eval function you can check out in their documentation. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to run Python safe eval, and that function comes from the pwn module here. And we actually want to use the expression, so .expr, and then we'll pass in S. I'll go ahead and print this out. Looks like Sublime Text won't want to run it, so I'll have it in my terminal here. We can just run Python ape, and you can see, okay, it has converted all of those different like bases, whether or not it be binary, decimal, hex, or octal, into just straight decimal. So what we can do now is do some handy list comprehension to go ahead and take the character values of all of these. Let's use character of x for x in that string or that list there, and we can go ahead and run this. And now you can see we've got some English text coming together. Let's go ahead and join these as a string. And now you should be able to see, hey, welcome to HackCon 18, organized, blah, blah, blah. Here is your flag. I wish all the tasks were this easy. Dart code. Sweet. So we could carve that out if we really wanted to. Let's do that just for nice practice, I suppose. Write our own get flag script. We don't need to import the whole namespace. Let's just import re, and then we'll say new s can equal that, re.findAll. With our flag format dark code, everything inside the curly braces and the current S. Let's print that out. We get a hit after we run it in the terminal. Great. Let's get the first element out of that, and that is our flag. Go ahead and move this if we wanted to. Make that ape our get flag script. Mark it as executable. Take that flag. Create a static file with it just in case our script no longer works for whatever reason, and we can mark that challenge as complete. So, simple and easy, pretty cool, just recognizing that it were just different kinds of bases denoting those numbers. Quick shout out to all my supporters on Patreon. Thank you guys so much. I cannot say it enough. $1 a month or more on Patreon will give you a special shout out just like this at the end of every video. $5 or more on Patreon will give you early access to everything they release on YouTube before it goes live, because I normally record in bulk and let YouTube gradually release them slowly on a schedule. If you did like this video, please do like, comment, and subscribe. Join our Discord server, link in the description. It is a cool community of CTF players, programmers, and hackers. You should totally join it if you want to hang out with me and other awesome people. We're going to tackle ICTF when it's coming up next weekend. I think Nighthawk CTF just got postponed, but there are some practice challenges, so jump on there and game with us. Hey, I would love to see you guys on Patreon, and I would love to see you in the next video. See you soon.